Everybody, good morning to all. I'm happy to welcome you all for this online class. We have successfully completed unit 4 and today we are going to see unit 5 prose, Water, the Elixir of Life. It was written by Sir Chandrasekhara Venkataraman. He was an Indian physicist born in Trichinopoly. He carried out groundbreaking work in the field of light scattering, which earned him the 1930 Nobel Prize for Physics. He discovered that when light travels at transparent material, some of the deflected light changes wavelength. This phenomenon, subsequently known as Raman scattering, results from the Raman effect and to commemorate it, February 28 is celebrated as National Science Day. In 1954, India honored him with its highest honor. In this lesson, Raman tried to bring about the importance of water, which has a unique power of maintaining animal and plant life. Water, the elixir of life, is the commonest of all liquids. Without water, the land will be barren like the deserts or in Egypt. On one side, it is a sea of sand. On the other side, laid one of the greatest, most fertile, densely populated areas, the Valley of Nile. It is separated by the River Nile flowing down thousands miles away. The entire soil is creation of River Nile. Egypt, in fact, was made by its river. Water in the countryside, which flows serenity, is the most beautiful sight. The rain-fed tanks, rare neglected in South India. However, these tanks play a vital role in South Indian agriculture. Some of those tanks are large and it is beautiful sight to see the sunrise or sunset over them. Water in a landscape compared to the eyes in a human face. It reflects changing modes of the day, bright and grey, sometimes dark and gloomy at other times. Water carries silt and finely divided soil and deposits in low-lying areas. The colour of water varies according to the place. Swiftly flowing water can carry fairly large and heavy particles. Large amounts of solid particles can be transported. Silt deposit land is very fertile. The flow of water has played a great part on the earth's surface. The flow of water can play a destructive part and wash away the soil, which is the foundation of all agriculture. The problem of soil erosion is one of the major problems we face today. Soil erosion occurs when soil on the earth's surface is carried away by wind or water, heavy rain, sloping land, absence of vegetation, roots through which water can flow down rapidly, an absence of cheeks in the course of its flow. The necessary measure or terracing of the land, building bunds to check the flow of water, canter cultivation, planting of right types of vegetation. Water is the basis of all life. Every animal and every plant contains water in its body. Water is essential for everybody, moisture in the soil is equally important for the life and the growth of plants and trees. The conservation of water is fundamental for human welfare. Much of Indian agriculture depends on monsoon. It is clear that the adoption of techniques preventing soil erosion would help to conserve and keep the water where it is wanted. In India, where we depend on seasonal rainfall, an immense quantity of rainwater runs off the ground. The collection of rainwater and utilizing the in very important vast areas of land which at present are scrub jungle. By courageous and well-planned action, it could be turned into fertile and prosperous country. The problem of afforestation closely connected with conservation of water supplies. The planting of trees in every possible way and the development of forest is one of the most urgent needs of India. Such plantation would check soil erosion and provide cheap fuel. The measures necessary to conserve water. What are they? Serves as a purpose of value to the life of countryside. Annex, the cheapest means of transport is by boats and barges through canals and rivers. There is development of rail, road transport, but a few measures are taken to improve waterways. The harvesting of water supplies usually makes possible the development of hydroelectric power. This would make a big difference in country life. It would also help to the top underground water. Water is thought a commonly found liquid. Unique because of its power to sustain plant and animal life. The investigation of nature and properties of water is therefore should be of highest scientific field of interest. Do you know the Great Pacific Garbage Patch? It is the world's largest collection of floating trash. It is in the Pacific Ocean between Hawaii and California and is often described as larger than Texas. Approximately 7 million tons of plastic and other debris up to 9 feet deep are floating. By estimating 80% of the plastic originates from land floating in rivers to the ocean, and the remaining 20% of the plastic originates from oil platforms and ships. These trash piles are the biggest threat to the sea animal. Do you think the living organism in this planet can survive without water? Why? No living things can survive without water because water is needed for the survival of the living organisms. Where do you get your drinking water from? We get drinking water from the borewells, from rain water. Is the drinking water you use in your home treated? Yes, many times. In our house, we use purifier. If not, how do you purify that? We can boil
and filtered for drinking water. The elixir of life, written by our writer Sir C.V. Raman, is said as Amrita. That means it is a divine liquid. Water is the magic of life. The elixir of life is water. Elixir is a magical or medicinal, or it's a medicine. Water is a magic for our life. Without water, we cannot survive. Sir C.V. Raman sees water as a beautifier of nature. It beautifies, it decorates the nature. If there is no water, all the nature will dry up and will make the world barren. The utilization of water should not be in a waste. We should not waste water. We should serve water. If water is not there, no life for us. We are using water for everything: washing, bathing, drinking, cleaning, for all other use. We are using water. Especially farmers use water for cultivation. If there is no water, no cultivation of crops, no food for us. So many farmers in South India, they use the rain water for cultivation. So it's a God's blessing for man to cultivate the crops. Rainwater is very, very essential. When the rain comes, we have to save the water for the use of cultivation. So if there is no water, it makes the land dirty and barren. Plain water is the elixir of life. So don't waste water. Save water, keep the water clean, and save all living organisms.
Precious water.
Don't waste.